cruise control, sometimes I will call it CC, functions in cars have existed for about 70 years. A short while ago, this useful feature was limited to certain car models. These days, cruise control seems to be standard on almost every type of car on the road. While it may seem insignificant, not being able to use the convenient cruise control feature can make any road trip less enjoyable. Although rarely posing a risk to safety, CC malfunctions must be diagnosed in order to be fixed and used again. Let's examine the typical reasons why cruise control doesn't work. Check engine warning light. When the check engine warning light illuminates, it typically indicates an issue with either your engine or transmission. Your cruise control system may be turned off as a safety measure by the engine control unit if it finds this issue. CC system will remain deactivated until the engine problem is resolved. Blown fuse. Fuse protection is applied to the cruise control system's electrical components. It is possible to blow a fuse just like inside your home. As a result, until the fuse is changed, the cruise control system will be disabled. Brake light switch. Typically, to disable CC, press the brake pedal. For this to occur, the cruise control system has to detect the brake light switch. This function will turn off automatically until the brake light switch problem is resolved if it is unable to detect the switch. Your brake lights staying on could also be the result of a broken brake light switch. Switch malfunction. Your cruise speed is adjusted using the cruise control switch. To maintain the acceleration speed, this data is sent to the CC module and engine control unit. The module and unit may not receive the required speed information to maintain the acceleration if the contacts inside the cruise control switch were to wear out. The system will completely deactivate and remove the current cruise acceleration setting in response. Vehicle speed sensor. The engine control unit and the cruise control module receive speed information about the vehicle from the few vehicle speed sensors found in the majority of cars. Your CC module will only receive this data from the vehicle speed sensors if that is how quickly the vehicle is traveling. The cruise control system will automatically deactivate if the speed sensor malfunctions and the module is unable to detect the speed. Electrical issues. The CC system is connected to multiple electrical components. When this feature stops working, you should definitely check the connectors, wiring harnesses, and ground straps. Verify that the voltage source is still providing the system with power. The cruise control not working would make sense if any of these parts were broken or loose. Throttle cables issues. Two throttle cables are used in older cars with cruise control, one for the gas pedal and another for the CC system. These cables might elongate with time. The cruise control system will not be able to operate the throttle plate correctly if the cable is broken or has stretched. Repair costs. You find yourself wondering how much it will cost to fix your cruise control after it decided to take a vacation. The cost of repairs varies based on the nature of the problem as well as the make and model of your car. You can get a general idea of what to budget for from this section. Let's examine the most frequent causes of cruise control issues and the approximate cost of replacing or repairing them. Blown fuse, $5 to $30. Quick and affordable to replace. Faulty cruise control switch, $100 to $200. A bit more expensive than a brake light switch. Faulty brake light switch, $50 to $150. Defective speed sensor, $100 to $300. ABS-related problems, $200 to $1,000. Can also be quite costly to repair. So that's it. Hope this information will help you to solve the CC-related problems. Don't forget to leave comments and press like or dislike buttons.